Are you looking for a small form factor, high output charging station to keep around your house? Or maybe are you looking for a very portable charging station to replace something that you might have brought with you on your travels? Well, then you're in the right place. Hello, I am Wanderer 001, and this is my review of the Anker 727 charging station, GaNPrime, which is fancy terminology for a lot of factors that Anker has put into this charging station. For starters, the charging station here is 6.3 inches in length with a width of 3.11 and a depth of only 0.7 inches. In comparison, if I put this up against my Pixel 5, it is slightly larger, but the depth, even with my Spigen case here, the charging station is not that much larger than it. So this is an incredibly small device for what you're actually getting out of it. However, it is a two-part system. The charging station itself is right here, but in order to use it, you need to utilize the included 5-foot power cable that comes with it. And this is a very beefy cable that plugs into the top of your charging station right here. And I bring that up because I want to actually turn on and power on the charging station. So that you can see right here in the middle, this Anker logo, when it is haloed in white, the device is currently putting out less than 90 watts. However, once this halo turns blue, you will know that you are outputting from this device between 90 and 100 watts. And part of the reason that it's hanging out in white is because I have nothing plugged into it right now, so it's in a power saving state. But let's say you don't like this halo right there. Well, if we come along to the side right there, there actually is a button that allows you to turn on and off the halo there. And you can see it kind of has a nice little pulse up and then a pulse down. I know those are not really things that you might be thinking of, but they're little cool add-ons, which is pretty much what this is all about, are little cool things that Anker has put together with this portable charging station. One of the problems, I'll say, is this flat surface here, this, including the halo, because you might think it, is not actually a charging pad. That's because all of the smarts that are part of GaNPrime are all packed down here. Because if we look up here, we have our two power outlets. And when I held it sideways, you notice how ridiculously thin it is. So you're looking at a standard power plug. Well, that's gonna shoot right through the back. How does that possibly work? Well, Anker came up with a clever design to have the outlet actually pop up to meet the device that you're plugging into it. And that is one of the space-saving things that you get with this charging station. So you have two outlets on the top, but a lot of us don't travel with wall warts anymore. I remember when I used my Belkin here, I would always have to have a bunch of wall warts and cables with us. Charging station here, don't have to worry about that. On the bottom, you actually have two sets of USB-C and two sets of USB-A. The USB-A over here uses their IQ technology, as well as both of these. However, this first one has a little computer icon right there, letting you know that's gonna be for your maximum output. Now, the maximum output of the power station is 100 watts. That is going to do you for a lot of your around the house electronics. There's only gonna be a few things that this cannot actually work with because the power consumption that they have is more than this can handle. But for everything that I threw at it, it was handling it like a champ. So let me show you a few of the tests that I was doing for the Anker 727 charging station here. But now we're gonna test the power station utilizing the power brick, which has to charge anyway. And how are we going to do that? Well, we are going to start plugging in devices to this to see if the wattage will change. So right now we're at 89.7, and I'm gonna stick in SwitchBot Hub Mini here. And we can see that that is still reading 89.7. We're gonna take a smart plug and add it to our power station. Let's see what that does. So it's fluctuating a little, 89.2 to 89.7, but that's not a lot. If I had some higher draw stuff from here, we would know for sure. Right now, if I bring over my tester here, this is drawing 100 watts. So the power station, charging the brick, with the Hub Mini with a smart switch. It's pulling 100 watts. I'm gonna plug in a computer power brick into the station here and see if that changes the draw. Nothing by just plugging in the power brick, so let's find out if we plug in the computer. All right, plugging in the computer into the power brick, still showing 89 watts. We're gonna crank up the computer to turbo mode and see if we can get it to drop that. It's moving between 89.5, 89.3, and 89.8, which might be a little hard to see there, but it is still actually feeding this the correct amount of wattage. And we have just opened our video editing software to get the maximum pull that we can from our computer. I hear my internal fans cranking up. And you can see, even doing that, power brick is getting its proper pull and the computer is getting its maximum pull. Throughout my test, I was trying to figure out how much wattage I can pull from this using different configurations as you saw. This is not just a basic slim form charger. Anker has put a lot of thought and technology behind this. They have things like their 7-point safety system, which integrates overvoltage protection, overcurrent protection. It's fire resistant because this will get a little warm if you're pulling 100 watts from it for quite a long period of time. I tested it out and got the charging station here up to about 129 degrees Fahrenheit. You also get short circuit protection, anti-static, which is good for electronics, grounding protection, also great, and over temperature control. And the over temperature control is part of their Active Shield 2.0 system, which monitors temperature up to 3 million times per day, letting you know, hey, this is not going to overheat if you leave something plugged into it and forget about it. If you're worried about those temperatures, don't be. On the bottom of the device, you actually have four rubber feeties, which will help lift this off of whatever surface you have it on. That heat is not transferred to the surface and is only emanating from the device itself. I have been a fan of Anker products for quite some time. With travel being a thing that people are doing again, I was in the market for a travel station, and this one fit the bill very nicely. Again, because of that very compact design and the fact that it has that 100 watt output. I can run my computer off of this if I needed to, but while I'm running my computer, I can also charge my phone and other accessories that I have brought with us. Because this is Anker's newest model, part of the Series 7, lineup that they're bringing out right now, it is not going to be a cheap station. I got this right when they launched it. I will say the price has come down recently, and if you keep your eyes open, you can pick this up on a really great sale, well under what I paid for it. But even with what I paid for this charging station, I would do it again. It is that good. The form factor alone for me makes this a buy. So if you're in the market for a slim design, portable charging station with 100 watt output, I would highly recommend checking out the Anker 727 charging station. With that being said, I have been Wanderer 001. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them in the area below. And as always, thanks for watching.
If you found this video helpful, consider giving it a like, as that will help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here, you can always help fuel the next review by buying me a coffee, link in the description below. Last but not least, if you want to be notified when I upload a new video, you know what to do.